had said in the Rig Veda 4,000 or 5,000 years ago was, let the winds of wisdom blow from all directions. Keep the windows of your mind always open. I think India doesn't need to advertise the fact that we have the largest diversity of practicing religions, of languages, of modes of dress, cuisines, forms of music, and all kinds of cultural expression, dance forms, and the like. And throughout this great diversity, we have also maintained an underlying spirit of mutual respect, giving space to people with different kinds of commitments, personal choices, and living in peaceful coexistence. We have a strong view in India, and I wish to share it with our very distinguished delegates who have come from many other countries, that it really doesn't matter in what name you address God, because if there is a divine entity and if we believe that there is a God or a divine entity from which we have all come for limited spans here on this earth plane, then certainly the divine entity was eternal. It had existed before we gave particular names or ascribed particular forms of address to him or her. And everything that we use currently as Ram, Krishna, Vaheguru, Jesus Christ, Allah, Khuda, are all bound in time. They started maybe a couple of hundred years ago, 1,000 years ago. But that entity is supposed to be eternal. It was ever present and shall ever remain. So how can a choice of a few words make a difference? And I'm very happy to say, and I'm sure that it's shared by all our distinguished delegates present here, that in their heart of hearts they know, and we have heard it from saints and sages of every single religion, that in the court of that Almighty, the only currency which has value or which is a currency of transaction is one of love, devotion, and humility. There's nothing more.